again. My name's Gabe Zolna. This is the 18th of February, 2019. Just received a rather interesting article posted by Think, Opinion, Analysis, and Essays. Michael Conway, Trump's emergency declaration may have laid the groundwork for his impeachment. You know who Michael Conway is? He's the husband of Kellyanne Conway. You know, I posted a video and I said it makes no sense to keep her within the administration. Not because she might not be a good employee, but because her husband relentlessly attacks President Trump. Michael Conway, Trump's emergency declaration may have laid the groundwork for his impeachment. Abuse of presidential authority was one of the articles of impeachment against Nixon. This president could be next. Written by Michael Conway, former counsel, U.S. House Judiciary Committee. The Founding Fathers pointed to the impeachment power of Congress through which a president could be removed from office for treason, bribery, or other high crimes and misdemeanors as the path to rein in a president encroaching on congressional power. In 1788, Federalist 66, for instance, Alexander Hamilton wrote that the powers relating to the impeachment are, as before intimated, an essential check in the hands of Congress upon the encroachment of the executive. In Federalist 65, Hamilton described as impeachable those offenses which proceed from the misconduct of public men, or, in other words, from the abuse or violation of some public trust. No greater abuse of public trust can be envisioned than the president usurping the power of Congress. That, however, is precisely what President Donald Trump's declaration Friday of a national emergency in order to commandeer billions of dollars that Congress refused to appropriate to build a wall on the southern border did. It is the constitutional role of Congress to appropriate, or in this case, refuse to appropriate public funds for a specific purpose. Congress voted not to fund $8 billion to build a wall, earmarking only $1.375 billion for that project. Trump's announcement is an effort to usurp those constitutional authority. As expected, the announcement promptly generated the first of several expected lawsuits challenging his declaration, but asking the judicial system to check Trump's hijacking of the constitutional power of Congress is the wrong tactic and is likely to fail. You want to read the rest of the article. It's somewhat interesting. And it's rather odd that President Trump would do what he did over building a wall when, as I've stated in countless videos, the wall isn't the answer. You can dig under it. You can fly over it. You can climb over it. What needs to be put in place is more control at the points of entry. They're not going to drive a tractor trailer across the Sonora Desert full of drugs. They're going to bring it through as they've done countless times. Sure, they lose a load or two, but they also get many loads through, or they wouldn't even attempt to get a load through. That's where the focus needs to be. Not on building a wall. This wall is simply a diversion so they can continue to do whatever the hell they want to do to us. That's you and that's me. Read the article. Pass it along to your like-minded friends. Repost it in your social media accounts. Ask your like-minded friends to do the same. Distract, divert, to deceive. That's all this is, folks. You think not? You're not thinking. The link will be attached.